Good morning students. In the previous class we have discussed about the non-communicable disease, and one example we have discussed is diabetes mellitus. There are two types that also we have discussed, and their symptoms, how to prevent and control the diabetes, that also we have discussed, and the differences between the two types of diabetes. Now next we are going to start about another non-communicable disease, which is called obesity. Obesity is the state in which there is an accumulation of excess fat with an abnormal increase in body weight. It's called obesity. So two things are taking place at obesity. First one, the accumulation of excess fat with the abnormal increase in body weight. This obesity may cause due to so many factors. That's why it is called multifactorial and chronic disease. What do you mean by chronic disease? Now, chronic disease is a disease which will be developing gradually, not suddenly. Chronic disease developing from social, behavioral, psychological, metabolic and cellular factors. So I told, so many factors are responsible for developing this obesity or non-communicable disease. What are the different factors? Now, first one is called social factor, behavioral factor, psychological factor, metabolic and cellular factors. Now obesity occurs if we are taking more and more calories, there is more and more food we are taking, then the expenditure of the energy. What is the meaning of this? If we are taking more and more food, that means calorie will be released or energy will be released, and that energy is not spent, not used. If we are not using that energy, it will be stored in our body in the form of fat. That's why obesity occurs if intake of calories is more than that of the expenditure of energy. Overweight and obesity are the conditions where the body weight is greater than the mean standard weight for age and height of an individual. Certain standard body weight is needed to maintain our healthy condition. If that body weight according to the height of the person is maintained, it is called the normal weight, and then in term it is called body mass index. But this body mass index sometimes in case of obese people will be more than that of the standard weight. By using the formula we can find out what is the normal body weight, and if the normal body weight, if the body weight is more than that the BMI, then at that time we can say the person is obese. What is that formula? BMI. What is the full form? Now, body mass index is equal to weight. Our body weight, suppose 72 kg, and that will be divided by height. Height means suppose my height is 160 cm. That we have to convert into 72 by 1.6 cm, meter square 1.6, then we have to divide it so we can find out the BMI. So this is the formula can be used to find out the BMI of our body. Now next, causes and risk factors. What are the causes? Already we have told different factors are responsible, and if we are taking more and more food and calories will be stored in our body, and we will become the obese. Obesity is due to maybe another factors, genetic factors. It may be physical inactivity. When we are very lazy to do any physical exercise, at that time obesity may develop. Eating habits, overeating, and endocrine factors. Endocrine factors related to hormonal secretion. Obesity is a positive risk factor. Due to obesity, there are different types of health problems we may get. What are the different health problems? Maybe hypertension. Hyper, that word is always in biology related to high, H-I-G-H. hypertension means hyper, too much tension will be there in our body. Diabetes, already we have discussed. Gallbladder disease, coronary heart disease. Coronary heart disease, the heart disease where the coronary blood vessels which are supplying blood to the heart will be affected. And arthritis is nothing but the inflammation of the joints, arthritis. So these are the different health problems we may get. So 2 marks question, maybe what are the causes? Obesity is caused due to genetic factors, physical inactivity, eating habits and endocrine factors. What are the risk factors? What are the health problems we may get due to obesity? 2 marks question. Now next part. Prevention and control of obesity. There are 2 different methods by which we can control the obesity. First one is diet management. Low calorie food we have to take, normal protein, vitamins and mineral, restricted carbohydrate and fat, high fiber diet, fruits, vegetables, greens to be taken can prevent the overweight. Calorie restriction for weight reduction is safe and most effective method by which, or measure by which we can control the obesity. Number 2, physical exercise. Low calorie diet accompanied by, along with moderate exercise will be effective in causing the weight loss. Meditation, these are the different other methods. Meditation, sometimes yoga and physical activity can also reduce the stress related over eating. So these are the different methods by which we can prevent and control the obesity. Again, 2 marks question, right? The preventive measures of obesity. First one, diet management. Second one, physical exercise. Third, non-communicable disease, which is called the heart disease. Heart disease, it is also called the cardiovascular disease, CVD. What is the full form of CVD? C for cardio, V for vascular, D for disease. Is associated with diseases of the heart and blood vessels. Coronary heart disease, CHD, it is also called CHD. Coronary heart disease is the most common form and is caused by, underline that one, deposition of cholesterol in the blood vessels that is causing the cardiovascular disease. It usually develops slowly over many years, beginning from the childhood. Many years means that is a chronic disease. Again, it is a chronic disease. Already we have discussed what is the meaning of chronic disease. They may form a fatty streak to a fibrous complicated plaque. I will show here if this is the blood vessel. Inside the blood vessels, fatty streak deposit. This fatty streak will be, this is the blood vessel. Now this fatty streak will become the fibrous tissue and it will become fibrous patches, which are called the plaques. These are called the plaques. It leads to the narrowing of the, so it is causing the narrowing of the blood vessels, leading to atherosclerosis. Underline the atherosclerosis is the large and medium sized blood vessels that are supplying blood to the wall of the heart. It leads to sudden ischemia. Underline there, ischemia means deficient blood supply to the heart muscle, which will lead to myocardial infarction, FARC, infarction, death of the heart muscle tissue. Now next, risk factors. What type of people will be getting this type of problem, heart disease? The first is the hypercholesterolemia. Hyper means always, I told that is in biological term, it is called high cholesterol level. Cholesterolemia, cholesterolemia, high blood cholesterol. Second one is high blood pressure, high BP, hypertension are the major causes and contributing factors for heart disease. And if it is not treated properly, may cause severe damage to the brain, kidney and eventually leads to stroke. that means brain stroke will be taking place. Second, this is called the cause. It may be the heredity, that means family history, diet rich of saturated fat and cholesterol, obesity, increasing age, cigarette smoking, emotional stress, sedentary lifestyle. Sedentary lifestyle means very not active, inactive lifestyle, not physical, no physical exercise. Excessive alcohol consumption, physical inactivity are some of the causes. What are the symptoms? Shortness of breath, headache, tiredness, dizziness, chest pain, swelling of the leg, and gastrointestinal disturbance. I mean, disturbances related to digestive system. Will be the digestive systems. Will be the symptoms. Okay, thank you, children.